Yeah, so in the previous videos, we talked about the VGG16 architecture and the residual network. Now I want to talk about a topic that is somewhat related to convolutional neural network architectures. It's not super important in terms of, let's say, implementing better performing convolutional networks, but I think it really helps like solidifying the understanding of how convolutions work. So the first topic I want to talk about is replacing max pooling with convolutional layers. And then in the video after that, I want to talk about replacing fully connected layers by convolutional layers. So both videos will be essentially about simplifying a neural network architecture by essentially getting rid of max pooling and getting rid of fully connected layers. It won't result necessarily in a better performance, but it is, I think, just an interesting thought experiment. So the first video here, in this two video series, it will be focused on replacing max pooling. So there's actually an architecture that is called the All Convolutional Network. It comes from a paper that is already 7 years old. It's entitled Striving for Simplicity, the All Convolutional Network. So here the authors propose replacing max pooling with a convolutional layer that has a stride of 2. And this is sometimes also called strided convolution. So in a traditional neural network or convolutional network, we have usually a convolutional layer with stride equals 1. And then we have max pooling, usually a 2x2 max pooling, also with a stride of 2. And then we have a convolutional layer again with a stride of 1. And we continue like that. And usually the convolutional layers, they preserve the size because we have a stride of 1. And the max pooling will reduce the size twofold. It will half the size. So the size that comes out of it is 1/2 if we have, let's say, a 2x2 max pooling with a stride of 2. And I can maybe also write this down. So the kernel size is usually 2x2 and this is a stride by 2. And this helps us also achieving a little bit of this location invariance. However, it's not essential to have that. So you can technically get rid of this and then just increase the stride here by 2 or here, and you will have the same effect that you reduce the size by 1/2. So I don't want to go into too much detail here, but if you look at the experimental results, when I recall correctly, they found that the performance slightly decreases when you get rid of this max pooling. However, how you can get an even better performance than before is by replacing this max pooling by a convolutional layer. Let me get rid of this 2 here first. So we have a 1 here, and then you can have a convolutional layer here with stride equals 2. And this will also have this 1/2 effect that it will decrease the size by 1/2. But instead of using the max pooling, you have the convolution, which has weight parameters, and you can think of it as something like a learnable pooling. At least that's what they argue here in that paper. So it will be, of course, a little bit more expensive because you have no more parameters, but in that way you can also simplify the network in terms of having it look simpler, by just saying, okay, we only use convolutions, we don't use anything else, if that's desirable. Of course, you still need the activation function, but you don't need pooling layers, for example. I recall there was a talk by Geoff Hinton. I don't recall the exact words, but I remember Geoff Hinton said something along the lines of that max pooling was one of the biggest mistakes in computer vision in terms of convolutional networks. Personally, I think it's actually not that bad. Max pooling works quite well. There's not necessarily an urge to get rid of this. So it's here more like a thought experiment how you can potentially simplify a neural network architecture. And then, talking about simplifying, so you can also get rid of the fully connected layer using convolutions. I will talk more about that in the next video. And another way to get rid of fully connected layers is by using global average pooling. So I'm not sure if this was the paper that kind of proposed that in the first place, I guess it was not, but this was nonetheless a nice figure. So usually we use these fully connected layers, like shown here on the left-hand side. We use these fully connected layers to map from the convolutional layer onto the number of desired class labels. So usually we have a fixed number of class labels, and in order to get from the feature map size to the number of class labels, we use these fully connected layers. So the first fully connected layer here would have as the input size the reshaped feature map size. So I think this will become more clear when I show you the code example. This is something you have seen before. It's not new. It may look a little bit different because I haven't shown that in a figure here. But this is essentially when we reshape so that it matches the size here in the fully connected layer. And what comes out of here, let's call that H, like some hidden dimension. It goes into the next fully connected layer. And here the output is then the number of classes. Of course, this fully connected part is usually very intensive in terms of lots of parameters. You can simplify this by using global average pooling. So here, what you do is essentially, first of all, you assume that the number of channels in the last convolution layer is equal to the number of classes. And global average pooling works essentially like that. You have heard about average pooling, which is just taking the average value. And global here means of the whole feature map. So you would technically just use the whole feature map here and then average over all these values. And this will be then the single value here. And then you do the same thing for the next one. So you just average over the whole feature maps. And that is also a way to get rid of fully connected layers. And by the way, here on the left-hand side, this is actually not necessary to have two fully connected layers. You could technically also reshape into this one, and this one takes out the number of class labels. It can be good to have a fully connected layer. It's like additional parameters to learn, but it's also not essential. You can just have all the parameters learned in this convolutional network and or convolutional part, and then have the global average pooling. And I will show you next code example how that works. And in the next video, I will also show you how we can replace that by an equivalent convolutional operation. Actually, there are two ways to do that. So personally, again, I would say there is no reason to get rid of the fully connected layers. They are just fine, and many or even most architectures use fully connected layers. But if you wanted to, you could technically also get rid of it. All right, let me show you in the next video a code example of an implementation of this all convolutional network. And I think this will probably make certain things a little bit more clear that I just was drawing here. All right.